It is Rohit Sharma who comes into the side. He's been out for a couple of months. He damaged a finger in the match in Cardiff. Long way away from here. And that was in the one-day series. So he's been out and he's going to open the batting. And he's got a decent set of numbers, averaging 35, strike rate at 78, and that incredible innings at 209 against Australia, Bengaluru.
Yes, that weather
around Rohit Sharma. A bit too leg side from Nguyen Khulasekara. He's got the in-swing going straight away, and what he's got to do is shift his line another foot outside that off stump, because everything's drifting down leg side. Well, that, oh dear, it had to go. Kisara Pereira is the man at third man.
Guy words. That is not what they're taught at the junior level, so certainly trying to do that, and this certainly was something that he could have taken with the fingers pointing downwards.
Good control.
That's the short delivery. Not from the middle of the bat. That'll be his first boundary for Rohit Sharma. You'll hang in there, you'll get the loose balls. Very good batting pitch again. Bowling at 118 Ks, you don't want to be bowling that particular length to a very good batsman.
Very fine, that's going to be four. Just straying a bit there in line. They had a beautiful line going earlier on, just about off stump.
The first four delivery that he's bowled. Rohit Sharma won't mind it. Needs a few runs under his belt. That's bread and butter shot from squared up completely. That's a good hit. Look majestic from Rohit Sharma.
He's trying to break the shackles. It's been hard work for the Indian batsman after the first four or five overs since then, but this was a good shot on the up. Hit through the line. He's a very good player when he plays well. He looks good.
Flipped away. Rohit Sharma finding his timing. He struggled early.
Full shots.
This is his strength. Again, like most of the Indian batsmen, uses the wrist really well. But Eranga cannot afford to bowl there to Rohit Sharma. There is a strong area.
More runs. In fact, four more runs.
Bowling to quality batsmen. He's sitting up in the wicket. Picked his pot with ease, Rohit Sharma.
The 71 balls for Rohit Sharma. He's on strike. Half century for Rohit Sharma on his return to this India side. Worked hard for these runs.
Had an early escape, but since
just pushing it away too long off, and everybody rising up in the Indian dugout in the Indian.
Two. Gone airborne, straight over mid-off. Four runs, Rohit Sharma, his sixth boundary.
Mendes wasn't doing anything, wasn't getting any purchase. So look at the confidence. The fielder is in the 30-yard circles.
Shimmy down the pitch and he makes it a full toss. Lovely ease of footwork there from Rohit Sharma.
Yes, he is. He's got the confidence. He's been there for a while, got the confidence after a half century. Very good use of the feet. And moving just a little bit towards the leg side so he can play through that offside field.
It became the highest run getter in Test cricket, going past Jeffrey Boycott. Shot, wide open space on that leg side, and it's very inviting for Rohit Sharma.
Rohit Sharma are really too worried when they play dot balls. They know a boundary will be coming along not too far.
Really easy now for the Indians. No pressure whatsoever.
just didn't pick it up. Ajanta Mendes down there at deep backward square by Virat Kohli. By Rohit Sharma, rather.
One more boundary for Rohit Sharma. That brings the 100 partnership between Rohit Sharma and Virat Kohli.
Because his deep fielders are long on, long off, and the mid wicket, which is on the leg side, so he cannot give room outside the off stump, even if pace comes off the ball. If pace comes off the ball,
both these batsmen continue and convert this 100 run partnership into a bigger one.
That's asking for trouble. Bowling shot and a slower delivery at that under 100 Ks. These are easy pickings. First six for Rohit Sharma.
Say the off stump, and this time rang short pitch deliveries. And when you're bowling to someone who is batting on 83 now, and you cannot afford to bowl that length. The fine leg has gone back. One more brilliant shot. This time an over-pitch delivery from Kulashekara.
Great over that for India. 16 runs coming. He asked for the batting power play, and what a start. Again, the slow delivery. 93 now. It's a lightning quick outfield. As a batsman, you don't have to worry. If yes, you'll know all about it. Hit the gap, you get good value.
Place the ball in between the fielders and it will race to the boundary, just like the one Rohit Sharma did in the last delivery. That boundary gets him to 97. See the timing and the placement, using his wrist, opening the face of the bat, hitting between the point and cover fielders.
There it is, the 100 moment. The fifth 100 in one day internationals. Very well played, young man. The dressing room happy. And he's happy as well.
After getting injured against England at Cardiff, and his strike rate 100 in just 100 balls, 100% strike rate. The first 50 runs he got in 72 balls, but the second 50 in just 28 balls. Has done in this game, a big moment for him. Got a big 100 in the practice game against Sri Lanka, getting his opportunity in this game, and how beautifully he has taken the opportunity. The entire team is delighted for the teammate Rohit Sharma.
Yeah, I'm a big Rohit Sharma fan, and good to see him back in the runs. And I think his celebration here has some extra meaning in it for me somehow. This celebration here. The sheer class and timing. It's an easy ball, but you still have to hit the gaps.
And both these batsmen cannot be stopped. Six almost hitting from outside the off stump.
Leon Bishop was talking about the speeds last delivery, 77 k's, so that gave the batsman a lot of time to pick a spot. Short fine leg, short square leg in, short on, because he's not a big turner of the ball. More runs. This is poor bowling.
Not at all convinced with the line, the bowling to both these batsmen. All Rohit had to do was put bat to ball. You cannot stop them getting boundaries or rotating the strike. Another boundary for Rohit Sharma. He's cutting loose. It also gets 150 run partnership between Rohit and Virat, giving himself some room and playing over the mid-off fielder.
Which they're becoming too predictable with both trying to bowl.
The third game he batted really well.
Good shot, but should have been stopped by the fielder. A sloppy work inside the ring. Erenga, the culprit, will run away to the boundary.
Can't afford to do that. Poor fielding. Batsman to be in top form.
and this is a great opportunity for them to get hundreds under their belt. Rohit Sharma is just toying with the bowling, just chipping it over the cover fielder.
Straight down the ground, it's another six. This is wonderful batting we're watching at Eden Gardens. It's a third six from Rohit Sharma.
Siku gave Prasanna in his first spell, but once the batsmen played themselves in, they've been toying with him. Nine.
Cuts this away late for another boundary. Excellent.
What record is he heading for now? There has to be some record close by. He has a lot of time as well. Another 14 overs after this.
That's exactly what I was thinking too. 209 is his high score.
Smashed away again. Four more. It's the 150 up for Rohit Sharma. He is blazing all over this ground. It's wonderful to watch.
Only 49 more to go.
Robin Uthappa is the new batsman. Straight over mid-wicket with absolute contempt for the ball bowled at him. Rohit Sharma hits his fourth six.
Another hit mid-delivery. Halfway down the pitch, and you can't bowl that to Rohit Sharma because he's in such good nick.
And the way he's playing, it will not take too much time for him to get that. One more brilliant shot. Rohit Sharma stepping out and hitting over the mid-off region.
Oh, this is a magnificent shot. Gave himself just that little bit of distance between the bat and the ball. The fielder was in the 30-yard circle on the offside at mid-off. So no protection at all.
Going round the wicket here.
It's gone quickly. Kolasekara couldn't get there. 300 comes up for India.
Kulashekara at long off position had no chance to stop it. Also, it shows how good a timer Rohit Sharma is.
Into the gap, and four more. He's climbing into some of this bowling. Well, he has been doing it for a while.
On the onside, beautiful use of wrist, piercing the gap between the cow corner and the long on.
11 fielders are not doing the job.
He's hit the gap again, and it's three boundaries in succession. Sonny wants more fielders.
Because look, there was a little bit of a gap there. Look at the way he's taken the ball early this time, and he's hit it square. Terrific. This is great batsmanship. Whatever the quality of the attack, however good the pitch is,
that is shockingly bad bowling, to be quite honest. That is terrible. 18 off the over, 315 for four.
That's poor bowling. It's okay to be hit off good deliveries, but you cannot afford to bowl short and wide to a batsman who's batting on more than 180. Format in any situation, and since then Rohit Sharma has been playing with a lot of fluency all around the park. Offside, onside, front foot, back foot, horizontal shots, vertical shots. Great display of stroke play.
It's back of the length, he's got protection in that leg side. Was the upper length, well played, magnificent from Rohit Sharma. What a beauty, 325 for four.
looking for the Yorker, and the fielder was very wide to capture this moment.
It's hit well, it's hit very well, and it's a moment of history for Rohit Sharma, first batsman to score two double hundreds in ODI cricket.
What an outstanding innings from Rohit Sharma. Right from the start, he was in total control of this innings. The entire team is so pleased for him, making a comeback of his sorts after his injury in England. The first batsman in the history of one-day international cricket to get two double hundreds.
Oh, it's high in the air. There's a fielder under it. There's a fielder under it. He drops it anyway. Might have been a question of its height, which is what Rohit Sharma is asking, but it doesn't matter. Inside out. Oh, what a wonderful stroke. What a fantastic range of shot making for Sharma.
He gets to his highest score with that brilliant shot. Not much room offered by the bowler, but
this is the moment when he got to his 200. Second time he's got 200. Must be a big relief for him. He was out of the game for a while with an injury. He's just made a comeback.
And that's really good to see. When your teammates celebrate with you for any milestone, that shows the kind of team bonding exists in the Indian team at the moment.
Oh, that's a solid crunch. Brings up the 350.
The free hit, this is a big no ball. It's a full toss on the pads, and he just helped it along. Not much effort there.
He is. Rohit Sharma now becomes the highest score in one day internationals. He goes past Virender Sehwag's 219.
Into the crowd at long off. Length ball, all right, but it still had to be put away. And he's done it with typical Rohit Sharma elegance.
High in the air. This could be a tester. And he's missed it as well.
It's getting from bad to worse for Sri Lanka.
Kulsekera back in the attack. Might run away for four as well. Everything that comes off anywhere near center of the bat is reaching the boundary.
And Rohit Sharma reaching out for that, slightly uppish, but well away from that fielder. No chance for that deep third man. Magnificent stuff. Don't forget, 29 boundaries as well, not just 7 sixes.
Over. Anyone close to it. And another boundary. Matthews, that expression says it all for me.
400 or not. It goes invariably off the middle of the bat. Oh, delicate, delicate, delicate. 100 partnership comes up. Uthappa has contributed to that as well.
How good was that? He's got answers to each and every question, the Sri Lankan.
Now that, how do you sum that up? That is toying. 382 for four.
Astonishing shot, look at that. He's moved away to the offside. And as the ball is wider, he still reached out for it. And he's brought his bottom hand into play. It's a flick. It's a flick over long gone for a six.
He can do anything on the cricket field. Everything coming out from the middle of the bat.
question about it. And that'll be another boundary, and he reaches 250 with that. Second batsman in the history of the game to score 250 runs in a limited overs game. But this is an international. The first man to get to 250 in one day internationals. Rohit Sharma. A great moment for him. Rohit Sharma.
One more six. This time straight down the ground.
It's raining fours and sixes at the Eden Gardens. A special place to play cricket. They're witnessing a special knock from a special player. Put in for seven.
That's 400. The 11th time in one day internationals that a team has gone past that landmark.
Once again, making it easy at that pace, giving width, bowling a length ball.
Out off the last ball of the innings. Mahila Jayawardena takes the catch. Deftly silence greets it, but what an innings. Record-breaking innings from Rohit Sharma on return to the Indian team. After 50 overs, 404 for 5 India.
Everybody from the Sri Lankan team, despite the fact that they've taken a hammering, very, very sportingly coming and shaking Rohit Sharma's hands. Everything.
Rival joy from his teammates as well as they enjoy his success.